A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 7th November, on the front page you have this news regarding government formation in Maharashtra, which is political news, we can skip it. Then here you have India aware of Pakistan motive on Kartarpur. So Pakistan's military has a strategic purpose in opening up the Kartarpur corridor, and India is aware of its ulterior motive to fan Sikh separatism in Punjab. So this is what government sources have said. However, Modi government said it is still committed to going ahead with the project due to be inaugurated as such. Then here you have 25,000 crore fund to help housing sector. So Centre, CBI and LIC will pool funds to help the housing sector. This was announced yesterday. The finance minister announced that real estate sector would be given a boost. And here you can see the alternative investment fund which has been announced to finance stalled housing projects. So this is the contribution by Centre, SBI and LIC, which totally come to 25,000 crores. So 1,600 stalled housing projects will likely be taken off. Even projects classified as NPS will be eligible. So this move, it is said, is likely to generate jobs and revive demand for building materials like cement, iron and steel. Then this is over 1,800 BSNL staff opt for VRS, that is voluntary retirement. Though we had seen how BSNL MTNL was proposed to be merged, and voluntary retirement was also proposed. It's a 70,000 crore revival package for BSNL and MTNL, which government had announced in October 2019. On page 5, you have man lynched, another injured in Jharkhand. So 5 persons, including a woman, have been held in this case in which a man was lynched and another seriously injured when a group of people thrashed them for allegedly stealing the battery of a truck in Bokaro in Jharkhand. And here you have farmers defy ban, 4,741 farm fires in Punjab on Wednesday. So we had seen the Supreme Court taking a stern view on stubble burning, and it had said even a single stubble burning in future would have the entire administration from the topmost chief secretary of the state to till the police official responsible for the incident. But still we see the farmers have defied the ban, and 4,741 farm fires were seen in Punjab. Sangrur and Bhatinda continue to be the worst affected districts. On page 9, you have Bhima Koregaon. Court denies bail to 6 activists. So, a Pune Sessions Court has rejected the bail plea of 6 persons, including advocate, former university professor, and activists. Then, here you have winds from India carrying pollutants. So, Sri Lankan authorities have issued an alert yesterday on the unusually high air pollution and asked people to exercise caution. They suspect that the winds blowing from northwest of Sri Lanka possibly carried pollutants from India. And here you have center plans to regulate fees at medical colleges. So Board of Governors as such has been asked by the Health Ministry to look into the matter, to do the groundwork. So aim is to eliminate the role of black money in medical education and make it accessible to all. And here you have Supreme Court asking the central government to give report on CIC posting, that is Central Information Commission. So Supreme Court has asked government to look beyond retired bureaucrats for appointments. And here you have India-Russia. So you should know Central Information Commission is the topmost authority under RTI Act, which is being diluted, we have seen, by the amendment to and by the appointments. So only retired bureaucrats are being seen for appointments, not human rights experts. Or it says that RTI Act of 2005 itself required people from varied domains to man the commission, and court found that official bias in favor of bureaucrats and government employees was evident from the beginning of the process of appointments. Then here you have India-Russia to form after-sales support group. So India and Russia have agreed to form specific working groups for after-sales support of key defense platforms and intensify efforts to finalize the cooperation program for 2021 to 2030. So we had seen an intergovernmental agreement has also been signed for mutual cooperation in joint manufacturing of spares in September 2019. So now working groups, after sales support groups will also be formed. Then here you have NGT issues ultimatum to ban certain RO systems. So this is reverse osmosis systems. So National Green Tribunal has given last opportunity to Union Environment Ministry to issue notification pertaining to prohibition on the use of reverse osmosis system, which results in wastage of almost 80% of the water. On the editorial page, the first editorial is judges for lawyers. So this says that judges should not reflexively take the side of lawyers who clash with police. So this is what happened in Delhi, and Delhi High Court took action against the police, which resulted in police protesting. We had seen that on front page yesterday. So this is in that context. And this Hazari Court and as such, where the incident also took place. And here you have Maulana's March. So this is the Azadi March in Pakistan. It's Maulana Fazlur Rahman's Azadi March to Islamabad, which is demanding resignation of Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan. So this is said to be the perhaps the biggest political crisis for Imran Khan, who has come to power in Pakistan in August 2018. So it is tapping into the rising public resentment against Imran Khan. And the lead article is, after RCEP opt out, the challenge of a shape up. So this is regarding India has opted out of RCEP, but it should shed its defensive mindset and trade deals and instead work on creating globally competitive sectors. So this is what this article argues. And here again, an unwanted booster dose for vaccine hesitancy. So the unchallenged spread of misinformation from a UN-based platform could affect the global vaccination program, is what this says. Because in January 2019, World Health Organization listed vaccine hesitancy as among the top 10 threats to global health this year. So vaccine hesitancy means reluctance or refusal to vaccinate despite the availability of vaccine. So this, it is blamed that even if UN-based platforms, put forth such perspectives, then it becomes difficult for common people to not have vaccine hesitancy. Then vaccine hesitancy becomes an issue. So here you can see the detail is provided. So, on November 1, self-styled yogi, mystic and visionary Jaggi Vasudev tweeted a dangerous message. He said the significance of vaccination against many debilitating diseases should not be played down. But at the same time, it is important, it is not overdone without taking into consideration the many side effects or negative impacts of vaccination. Then British physician who linked the measles, mumps and rubella vaccine with autism. So MMR vaccine can result in autism. So such viewpoints being given in India as well as globally results in a threat to health in the future. This is vaccine hesitancy. Then on the op-ed page you have, as the seas come closer. So it says most people at risk from coastal flooding live in Asian developing countries such as India and China. So large portion of coastal cities like Mumbai could be fully submerged by 2050, according to a study. And this is security compromised. So it says India's claim to be a legitimate power in cyberspace has come under doubt following two recent revelations regarding Kudankulam nuclear power plant. There a malware being seen and the WhatsApp Pegasus spyware. So India's security has been compromised in cyberspace. And here you have pollution as a PR opportunity. So partnering with ride-hailing apps is no solution to problems posed by unclean air and congestion. Uber launched such things, leave your car behind. So this is advertising, but then this is not going to solve the problem. On page 13, you have replicate Kartarpur model. So Manmohan Singh says it may be used to resolve conflicts in future as well. The way Kartarpur corridor will result in connectivity between India and Pakistan, this model can be replicated further, is what is being endorsed. And this is plea to review second judge's case order dismissed. So, nine judge bench rules on grounds of the delay of over 9,000 days in filing the pleas and on merits. So, but it rejected the review of second judge's case. And this is Telecom and IT Minister Mr. Prasad. He has said that India won't accept data monopoly. So there is large amount of data which is generated in developing and underdeveloped countries, but it is said only developed countries are putting emphasis on processing this data. So data monopoly would not be accepted, as we have had data localization too, that India wants all the data generated from its country to stay within its boundaries. On international page you have US envoy admits Ukraine quid pro quo. So this is US ambassador to European Union, who has in an updated testimony has said that aid was tied to Ukraine launching probes into Trump's rivals. So quid pro quo means give and take. So President Trump was asking Ukraine to launch an investigation against his rivals, and then he would provide aid to Ukraine. So this has been admitted by US ambassador to Europe. And here you have Xi Macron call climate pact irreversible after US pullout. So this is Chinese leader Xi Jinping and French President Emmanuel Macron. They declared that the Paris climate pact was irreversible. So they have put a united front after Washington formally withdrew from the Paris climate agreement, which we saw in news yesterday. And then, though USA had announced it long back, but formally it was able to pull out on 4th November 2019. Then here you have sharp rise in H-1B denial for Indian firms under Trump. So denials as such have increased from 7% to 53% in case of Wipro, and from 2% to 45% in case of Infosys. So there's sharp rise in H-1B denials. On business page you have builders give thumbs up to cabinet's booster shot for realty. So this funding, which has been announced, which we saw on the front page, 25,000 crore funding, will help expedite projects. And here you have RBI panel moves tighter norms for CICs, that is core investment companies. So RBI has set up a working group to review the regulatory and supervisory framework for core investment companies. And it has suggested that such entities should only have a two-tier structure and stronger boards with at least 50% independent directors. And below you have IMF, International Monetary Fund, says that government lags G20 in fiscal transparency. So India needs to be more transparent on the fiscal numbers, that is, it is at laggard among the G20 peers on this front. So this is what IMF has put forth, that credible fiscal consolidation is as such has to be achieved. And on the last page you have Chinese experts to help in restoration of Notre Dame. So it is said Chinese experts are skilled at renovating wooden structures. You should remember the famed France's Notre Dame Cathedral, which had caught fire. So this is an 850-year-old cathedral, which was scarred in April 2019 after a fire tore through its roof and toppled its spire. It is the most visited historic monument in Europe. So that is it. These are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aasha.com. Thank you.